If you're currently suffering from shoulder pain and confused about what's causing it, this is the video to watch. For those who don't know me, my name is Dr. Zach Greenwood, and in this video, we're going to show you how you can accurately and concisely figure out whether your shoulder pain is being caused by shoulder impingement, a rotator cuff tendonitis, or a rotator cuff tear. Your rotator cuff are four muscles on the back of your shoulder blade and that come around your shoulder. And they're the supraspinatus, the infraspinatus, the subscapularis, and the teres minor. And these muscles work as a group to functionally and dynamically stabilize your shoulder or the ball and socket joint right here. An important thing to note is the supraspinatus muscle and tendon, the one here on the top, is the one that's most commonly affected by the following conditions. And the way this video is going to work is we're going to go over each of the conditions separately, showing you how they most commonly feel or present, and then the best test. And then the upper left-hand corner of each of the sections is going to be a different video with a link to it of the exercises for the condition. So once you know what you have, click on that link and it'll give you the best exercises to help resolve it. First, shoulder impingement. And this is probably more aptly named as shoulder subacromial pain because again, when you raise your arm, shoulder impingement thinks that you're kind of wearing out or irritating that tendon. But again, as the tendon raises up, it kind of slides back and forth. And so when you have pain, it's much more about irritation than the tendon wearing out. So we may need to avoid certain positions and movements, but again, it's really important to think that it's irritation, not damage. And with this condition, it most commonly presents as anterior lateral or pain on the outside of your shoulder, worse with motions such as raising your arm over your head or behind your back. It most commonly presents in young athletes, especially overhead throwers, and the pain is usually sharp and stabby, and it gets worse the more you do it. If you please like the video, subscribe to our channel, and then click on notification. The goals of rehab for this condition is to progressively strengthen the muscles, work on controlling that shoulder blade better, and then working on upper back extension or T-spine extension. And the best test for this, and again, the more tests you have that are positive, the more likelihood that you have this condition, is the Hawkins-Kennedy test, the infraspinatus muscle test, and then the painful arc. So if this sounds like something that you're presenting with, here's a video link in the upper right-hand corner and you can click on it, which will bring you to the video covering shoulder impingement and you can start working on addressing your problem. The next condition is rotator cuff tendonitis, or affecting that tendon of that muscle group. And with tendonitis, that makes us think that it's an inflammatory process, so rest and ice is the most appropriate treatments. But tendons get irritated not by inflammation, but by when more load is placed than the capacity for them to handle. So rotator cuff tendinopathy is a more appropriate term, and load management is the key to addressing tendon issues, where you try to place just enough to get it a little stronger, but not so much that it gets overloaded or so little that it gets underused. And with this condition, there's often a constant ache in the front or the back of the shoulder, and the cardinal symptom is weakness and pain. It most commonly presents in males about 30 to 40. And another key is if you lay on your side and it really hurts, there's a good chance that you have rotator cuff tendinopathy. Two other things to be aware of with this condition is it usually improves with rest and it gets a little better as you warm up. So if you have some discomfort when you start, but it gets pretty good during, then it probably is this. One thing to note is sometimes you won't notice if you overload it till the next morning. So with this condition, it's really important that the exercises feel okay during and there's no elevation of pain the next morning. The best test is the internal rotation test is much, much stronger than the external rotation test. If this feels like what you have, again, here's that video card in the upper right part of the video and you can click on it to address the exercises that are gonna help you manage this condition. The next thing we're gonna talk about is rotator cuff tears. Now there's a couple important things we gotta talk about before we talk about how this presents. So the first thing is, think of the tendon as a blanket, not a string. And so if a little bit gets cut, your blanket is still probably pretty good if you only have 5% of your blanket torn. The next thing to think about tears is don't think of them as like this, but they kind of get torn in the middle. And so again, if you only have a 10% tear, your tendon is still really strong. So there's a lot of good evidence to say that most tears that aren't full thickness can be resolved just as well with exercises as surgery. So don't think, well, if it's torn, why am I doing these exercises? Because again, your body has an amazing ability to adapt and get stronger if you do the right exercises at the right dosage. With tears, there's a large function of just that it gets a little bit more prevalent as we get older. So this is more common in 50 and 60-year-olds than 20-year-olds. And with this pain, it's often a dull, throbby pain, and it may even feel like it's deep underneath your shoulder blade. There may be some associated weakness, but it's not the same as tendon because it will get usually worse the more you do it. Four easy tests that you can do on yourself to rule out a full thickness rotator cuff tear. The first is the external rotation lag sign. The second is the dropping sign. The third is the hornblower sign. And the last is the internal rotation lag sign. If after hearing this feels like what you have, here's that video card to the link on the video we made for rotator cuff tears. And again, most rotator cuff tears can be managed with just exercise. We're gonna cover a quick summary of the conditions that we just talked about. So for shoulder impingement, again, it's on the anterolateral part of the shoulder, most common in 20-year-olds, especially overhead or throwing athletes, and the pain is sharp and stabby. Rotator cuff tendonitis or tendinopathy, again, this is more of a dull, achy. It's usually better with rest and a little better as you warm up. Most common in 30 or 40-year-old males, and again, there's pain and weakness associated with this condition. Lastly, rotator cuff tear. Again, this is more prevalent in 50 years or older. It's more often to have a throbbing or deep pain, and depending on the tear, there can be marked weakness if it's a full thickness tear or just mild weakness if it's a partial tear. And remember, with tears, think blanket, not rope, and you can have a 10 or 20% tear in your blanket and the blanket still functions. So again, we can exercise this condition. If you found this video helpful, please like it, subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to check out our other great videos.